when you turn 18, you're now an adult. And when you're an adult, people expect you to be more mature, more quiet, more well-presented.
People want me to, you know, live the simple life, get a nice little office job, get a husband, be a housewife, all that jazz.
It's not as simple as that, and it's really annoying.
My parents want me to sit at home, be quiet, do my work.
You know, they want you to be modest, they want you to cover up, they want you to be more respectful.
Ladylike, pristine, proper.
I'm just not that kind of person.
Head down, chin up, crack a smile, but not like that.
You can't be loud, you can't be excitable.
Be reserved, don't go out, don't be with your friends, don't party.
I think I might lose my mind if one more person tells me to keep quiet.
You're a grown-up. It's time to act your age.
Guess what happened?
Something I think about a lot, because everything is finite, everything is limited, but nothing is ever guaranteed.
What kind of crap is this?
I've tried so hard to be a man, a boy. I've tried to like football, I've tried to
finish school, go to uni, get a job, meet a man.
I've got a whole life, I've got the world to explore.
I start smiling.
You know, do all that stuff. And then I realised nothing is really stopping me from being
being an LGBT person. Like, when am I ever going to be able to trust anyone?
Lust and anger, greed.
We haven't had a war in a while, which means it's only a matter of time.
I've seen way too many movies.
It's something that really makes me mad.
But yeah, so if we come from different backgrounds, the same backgrounds, there'll always be something that separates one person from another.
Sitting in my room every day, thinking like,
we are never guaranteed tomorrow.
That's the whole point of these shows and things.
We are terrified of our lives starting and continuing without us.
Because why get our hopes up and make plans when we may not even have enough time?
The shit that we're giving other people or ourselves.
We're running out of time to fix things as humans that we've done to the world.
We'll just push that to the side, because do you know what? Coronavirus cases have slowed down. Wonderful. Why did we have so many in the first place?
With that as an example,
all of us humans are flawed.
Conflict can be a very powerful source of knowledge. Conflicts can make people stronger.
It's a killer bee.
There will always be conflict. It's how you handle the conflict that matters.
I like to think, what could I have done if I was born later? Then I think, if I were born later, I wouldn't be able to do the things I can do now.
Once I realised it's up to me, I can like what I like. I'm still fighting every day to get permission to be me from strangers, and it's stupid. Like, it shouldn't have to be like that.
And it's all about seizing that moment and being there and being in the present and taking hold of every opportunity you're given and finding them and making them, and not just relying on the world to do the magic for you.
Or do it now, then it might never happen.
You might have got an A or a B, or you haven't got the good grade in music. People don't believe you can do it. You could produce a music video that absolutely blows everybody away.
And creativity makes the world go round, baby. But no, you know, if you've got the money, it works out for you.
Any time today, bro.
Hey.
Bro, we're waiting on you. So you're filming yourself answering these questions about yourself.
Oh, I was going to say, no one's asked me any bloody questions. Jesus.
Oh, I love you, bro.
Okay.
So I think I'm going to jump in the frame. Hey guys, it's me, your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. Today, I thought I'd let you guys... I can't, I do words.
God, we found the thing that links us already, Drag Race.
My drag name is Raya Search. Did you just Google me? Because you just got Raya searched. Bang.
Love that.
A typical outfit Katie would wear on a night out, I feel like would definitely be like black trousers. Quite a like black outfit. I feel like you're quite like, definitely tattoos on show. 100%, even though one of them's a bit wrong, but that's okay.
It gets lonely in Katie's room when she leaves, having no one to talk to but that obnoxious half-drunk bottle of Palm and Violet gin in that corner. I just can't help thinking that I was meant for something more. Being lifted towards the pursed lips of kings and queens. Or what if I met a sexy mixer and we combined our flavours to create the most amazing drink in the world? Oh, Katie's back. I think she's crying. Oh, she's definitely crying.
Ugh. What's up, guys? Why do I sound like a YouTuber?
Bag of chips is class.
Bag of chips is sexy. She takes it out. And...
So, at the end of a night out, Becky would definitely order like the biggest kebab she could get, like the biggest, most expensive one on the menu, like the proper greasiest one she could find, and probably cheesy chips.
Literally the fattest kebab that you could find would be my kebab.
Every day I wake up feeling optimistic about the adventures that possibly lie in the day ahead. Sometimes we end up in a shop, and sometimes we end up in a park. And the best part about it is, I never have to worry about my biggest fear of being worn out, because for some reason, my owner's feet never seem to touch the ground. Mysterious.
If Katie was a song, I feel like she would be Africa, Toto.
A good shout, because it's a brilliant song, but I think it's a bit too upbeat for me. So it'd probably be something like Pumped Up Kicks, because it's like really like, it's catchy and it's like people love it, but the lyrics are actually really depressing and really sad. So I think that's pretty good.
I'll catch y'all on the flip side. Whoa!
What?
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 Is your tea?
I'm busy!
Okay, your tea!
Oh, damn!
Hi, it's me. The mirror, sit on your desk. You know me, we know each other. I see you, you see me. It's a system. You know, you put your makeup on and we look at each other for a long time. And I get to see power, strength, someone who refers to themselves as an icon. And I would agree. Someone who's overcome a lot of things. You should feel proud of that. I've also seen you cry. You don't like that I've seen that. Because you don't think it's okay to be vulnerable. To show any kind of emotions, whereas it is. You don't give yourself permission to be vulnerable. You think it's not okay to cry, but it is. It's okay to feel a range of emotions. You can bring laughter, but you can still feel the things you need to feel. Right? But again, what do I know? I'm about $5.99 from a B&M bargain sale. My opinion isn't all that high and mighty, but I'd still listen to it. But you know, it is what it is.
Love me when I'm powerful.
Love me when I'm small.
Love me when I'm used to pain. There's nothing left at all.
What makes someone beautiful?
When will I find love?
How will I know when they know what I've been thinking of?
I've been caught one word for all of my life. I had no idea I'm so strong inside.
Love me when I'm finding out
who I'm gonna be.
Joke is over, will you love me without me?
Tell me it's okay and that you won't disappear.
When I find my feet,
can you love me without me?
tall.
I'm an icon in the making, like the next chef from Dalo.
Hey. Will you love me in my future?
Love me in my past. Love me in the here and now, however long this lasts.
I know I am some kind of wonderful. I will love myself. I am beautiful. I know I am some kind of wonderful. I will love myself. I am beautiful.
The reasons why I enjoy choral singing is because I feel like I don't feel trapped by it. I can release my energy into my singing and I can enjoy expressing. I don't like pop music. Like, I have a playlist dedicated to Christmas carols and church hymns because I just like the way they sound and I like to sing along to them. If you enjoy singing, you'll enjoy being in the choir.
Right now, where are you living?
Oh, UK.
Yeah, but where?
East London.
Oh. Some of my friends are Portuguese and they've got last name, is you?
I can get to the Angolan side and I can get to the normal Portuguese dish. My favourite one is feijoada. So it's basically like beans with hella meat. There's so many meat that you cut. And then it has cabbage. I mean, not cabbage. What's it? What is it? Them soggy lettuce thing. But I can't explain it.
My grandma's sag. It's like, do you know what? It sounds disgusting and it looks disgusting, but it tastes so nice. So it's just like spinach, like every single horrible vegetable you could think of is in it, but it tastes so nice. Like, I didn't even know it was made of vegetables and it used to be my favourite, and then they told me when I grew up and I was like, what? And I was walking on with my boyfriend the other day, but my boyfriend's white, and we were walking down these steps behind my house and they're really dark, and it's just like, they're called the death steps, so that just kind of explains it all. And then these like girls, they were quite young, so I was a bit surprised. I just walked past them, like, I didn't even look at them. And then she called me, she kept calling me, well, I don't want to say it, like the P word, do you know what I mean? And then my boyfriend was like, what are you saying to her? Like, she's like, been spoke to you. And then all the friends were like, oh, ignore her, she's really drunk. And I was like, yeah, but that's not really an excuse, is it? Like, and then her friends all messaged me and they were like, oh, she was just drunk, don't take it too far, like, it's not important. And I was like, okay. I just thought, if it were like a young kid and she'd said that to them, like, could you imagine how they would have felt? Like, it would have been horrible.
I almost got arrested for the colour of my skin. Honestly, I have an aggressive face, so people would think that I'm up to something. It was me and five of my boys. And bear in mind, four of them are black and one of them are just white. How comes a bully van pulls up? The white guy that was in a car, he was smoking all types of stuff. They got out of the car and then they immediately saw the white guy, but they left him in the car. They put me in a cuff, right, yesterday. And then I was just looking, I was like, wow, you're really arresting us. But what about the white guy? Bro, we're not these type of so-called black people that put everyone in danger. No, not every black people are dangerous people. We're just civil people, that's it. So, yeah.
Once upon a time, we decided that the universe didn't deserve us. No gods could judge us, no systems could restrain us, no laws could deter us. Shredding expectations and encouraging eccentricities, we decided to live solely for ourselves and each other. Chasing our destinies to the ends of the earth, we'd kicked out into the dirt like it was nothing, because it is nothing. We tower over it all, becoming higher than the heavens, the second we stop letting fear control us. Sliding into the passenger seat, we gave ambition the wheel, so we could finally take that back road to happiness in a reliant robin fueled by love. Ignore the scratches. and the dents and the way the engine rattles, because fuck it all, we're not failing our MOT today. We've got better things to do. Better places to see, better people to be, better lives to live, a future to rein in, because the past doesn't matter. And in a moment, neither will the present. Failure is fake, and we are invincible.
Togetherness, trust, and loyalty. Be your own identity. Have faith in God.
Or not.
It's up to us. Among all the noise, I can finally hear my own. Now I've found my place, I can stand in my zone. I am confident, and I feel good in my soul. We don't need another to tell us who we are. To it for the culture, our voice has got the power. Speak it, sing it, say it loud. To make our voices heard right now, we stand proud. Among all the wrongs, I can finally put things right. Now I've grown my wings, I am ready to take flight.
There's 7 billion people on the earth. Of course, we're all not going to get along. I love ready salted crisps. You might hate ready salted crisps. The delicious salt, maybe I can't understand that, but I can accept it. And we both like eating, right? I'm doing this project, and I don't know what half these people are like or what the views are, but I do know that we have one thing in common, and that's that we all done Youthquake. Because we're united in that, we've got to know each other. We've made a Snapchat group and we've talked. We've came together and we haven't focused on the things that make us different. And we're getting on just fine. It's working just fine. Regardless of whether we love or hate, Reggie Salt and Crisps.